Because nothing is as awesome as a horny ape. Hey rabbits, it's Trixie and welcome to a new video. I am pretty sure that the German language seems like a jungle to many of you who are trying to learn it. A jungle of weird sounding words, grammar rules and expressions. So I bet that it doesn't surprise you much that this jungle is inhabited by lots and lots of monkeys.
Jungle? Monkeys? What the heck are you talking about?
Hey, just trying my best on a creative introduction. Fine, this video is about German words and expressions concerning monkeys. Because we have a lot, for some reason. So let's get started. Nothing more to say except for... You know what's coming, right?
You're gonna make a monkey noise.
Oh, yes. First of all, in German you say der Affe to a monkey and to an ape. We don't really differentiate there. And I have to admit that I had to look up the difference myself because I didn't know before. So basically it's very simple. The main difference between a monkey and an ape is... you're gonna have to look that up for yourself. This is not a biology channel. But der Affe is not only the name for an animal in German. It can also serve as an insult. Calling somebody du Affe means that this somebody behaves very ridiculously. He or she acts foolishly or cannot be taken seriously. Schatz? Hier, guck mal. Okay, ein Plastikstäbchen. Und da ist ein kleines pinkes Plus-Symbol. Oh nein, Elisabeth, du hast hohes Fieber? Leg dich schnell ins Bett. Horst, ich bin nicht krank. Ich bin schwanger, du Affe. Alternatively, you can take this insult a bit further and refer to one ape's body part in particular. In German, you can say du Affenarsch, you monkey or ape butt. Another term concerning monkeys is Affenschaukeln, ape swings. This is a fancy name for a certain hairstyle, nowadays, if at all, mostly worn by children. I actually wore ape swings already, talking about funny German names for body features. So this is pretty much what that looks like. Next up, a common expression that I find very funny.
Du bist wohl vom wilden Affen gebissen.
You must have been bitten by the wild monkey. And yeah, it's the wild monkey. Must be a legend or something.
Okay, so let me see if I got this last one right. You think that Trixie's videos are educational and fun? Du bist wohl vom wilden Affen gebissen.
Ah, yeah. Very funny. Thank you. Are you done?
No, actually not. Es ist wirklich eine... Affenschande, dass jemand wie du überhaupt Videos machen darf. Look at me, I'm Trixie, a talking cleavage. I'm so cute and pretty. Let's learn German together.
Hör auf mich nachzuäffen. That's seriously enough now. Shut it. Klappe zu, Affe tot. Next up, an adjective that I personally use pretty often. Affig. Monkey-y or ape-y. It basically means ridiculous or silly. Findest du nicht, dass das ein bisschen affig aussieht? Tja, wenn die Aliens Kontrolle über dein Gehirn genommen haben, werden wir ja sehen, wer hier affiger aussieht. Höchstwahrscheinlich immer noch du. Now to spice things up a little, here is an acting performance for you. Try to find as many ape-related words or sayings as you can.
Oh, ich hoffe, ich mache mich jetzt nicht zum Affen. Aber ich tu's. Ich schaff das. Ich muss es einfach wissen. Thomas?
Ja?
Hey, Thomas, du, ich wollte dich fragen. Puh, ist es eigentlich heiß hier drin? Ich glaube, mich lost der Affe. Es ist heiß hier drin, oder? So eine Affenhitze. Okay, ich sag das jetzt. Ich finde dich mega süß. Möchtest du heute Abend mit mir ins Kino gehen?
Ui, zugegeben, ich habe auch einen Affen an dir gefressen. Ich finde dich ehrlich gesagt affengeil. Dann lass uns mit Affenzahn ins Kino fahren, okay? So, how many did you find? First of all, there was den Affen machen or sich zum Affen machen. To make the monkey or to make the monkey out of yourself. This basically means to make a fool out of yourself. Then there was ich glaub mich laus der Affe. I believe the monkey is delousing me. I wonder if it's the same, the monkey. The legendary wild monkey, maybe? This simply means I cannot believe it. You're surprised or shocked, can be in a negative or in a positive way. Next up, die Affenhitze, the monkey or ape heat. That's this typical kind of heat that is difficult to stand. You know, this kind of deep summer heat where you're just melting away and all you want to do is eat ice cream and sit in front of the air conditioner? Still three more to go, just taken out of this little example. One expression was an jemandem einen Affen gefressen haben. To have eaten a monkey on, about, of, not sure about that word, somebody. That means that you fancy somebody or something. You are crazy about a certain thing or a certain somebody in a very positive way. And of course, how could we forget Affengeil, another very interesting adjective. It basically means horny as an ape. And it describes something amazing, something truly awesome. Because nothing is as awesome as a horny ape, I guess. And lastly, Affenzahn, or with Affenzahn, meaning ape tooth or with ape tooth. And that means with speed, fast.
Like in Ich schalte lieber mit Affenzahn Trixis Video aus.
Moving on. The word I want to end this video with is Affentheater, monkey or ape theater. It means drama, noise, charade, crazy business, a big deal. There is a lot of fuss that you don't understand about something. Affentheater. Oh, was soll ich jetzt nur machen? Wie konnte ich nur so dumm sein? Jetzt mach doch nicht so ein Affentheater. Im Leben läuft eben nicht alles nach Plan. Affentheater? Ich weiß doch nicht mal, wer der Vater ist. So, what role does the monkey have in the German language? It is a symbol of foolishness, of mockery and embarrassment, but also of affection, of speed and awesomeness. A twisted picture of the monkey in the German language makes us draw the dramatic conclusion that... Alright, Babbits, I really hope that you enjoyed today's video and that you learned one or two new things. If so, please leave a thumbs up because that would make me really, 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 really happy. Of course, if you want, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook, and here is a video that you should definitely check out as well. Subscribe to Don't Trust the Rabbit for more videos like this, and hopefully we're gonna see each other in my next video. Bye!